Hello there. This is lecture number 6 for Missional Church, and this is some information that I've got to get into your hands. There's no way that we can complete a course on the Missional Church without understanding what life transformation groups are. Now, I'll just tell you, I've been studying church planting movements, church planting, methods of starting house churches and disciple making, and raising up leaders for the harvest. I've been studying these issues since I was 16 years old. I'm 29 now. So in 13 short years, I have been searching for something that is simple enough and healthy enough to be able to multiply disciples on the core level of answering the question, how am I a disciple of Jesus Christ? How do I maintain my walk with God? And then how do I train someone else to walk with God? Because going back to the church planting movement, envision, in order for us to multiply God's heart in a healthy way, in an indigenous way, and focused on multiplication, the only way to do that is abide in Him and be faithful to prayer. So how do we keep ourselves accountable to do that? Because that is the big question, okay? How do we make disciples? That comes from the heart of the task. And we've studied a lot. We've gone over a lot of material in this course already. But I think one question we haven't answered yet is, across people groups, across cultural environments, no matter what the language is spoken, what is the biblical New Testament model for making disciples? And I can tell you this right now, after 13 years of studying these issues, I have not found a more simple and reproducible model for multiplying disciples. So this comes from missiologist and church planting trainer Neil Cole out of his book, Cultivating a Life for God. So let me first of all say, I could not more highly recommend this as a model, a biblical model, taking biblical principles for you and me being disciples and being faithful to this process. You and I can go out and start life transformation groups with anybody right now, and I could not more highly recommend that you do that right now. So Neil Cole started Church Multiplication Associates, and here's their mission from their website. Now, I've also uploaded under the websites folder and your resources folder for this course the link for you to learn more about this information. But what is Church Multiplication Associates? Their mission is, we exist to support and encourage church multiplication movements by developing new resources focused on reproducing healthy disciples, leaders, churches, and movements from the place where you're planted and finishing at the ends of the earth. And so you can see this model and these principles are right in line with our church planting movement envision that we've talked about potentially launching in each of our contexts as the missional church. So what is an LTG? LTG stands for Life Transformation Group. An LTG is a simple way to release the most essential elements of a vital spiritual walk to people who need Jesus. LTGs encourage and support people to follow Christ by fueling internal motivation rather than applying external pressure. This tool empowers the common Christian to accomplish the uncommon work of reproducing spiritual disciples who can in turn reproduce others. An LTG is simple yet powerful. It incorporates the values of community, internal life transformation, and reproduction of disciples. And I think the key here is going back to the third bullet point, and that is that, how are we going to make disciples? How are we going to reproduce leaders? How are we going to plant church planting movements? How are we going to launch gospel movements? It all comes down to whether or not I'm abiding in Christ and I have God's vision for the world. And the only way to do that is that I've got to follow Jesus. I've got to have an ongoing healthy relationship with Him, because I have to receive from the Spirit living in me an internal motivation to fuel me to obey God to make disciples. And so that's the power of this life transformation group, is we can take anyone with any past, zero theological training, zero education, and a life transformation group can teach them and keep them accountable to being a disciple and making disciples. So what's the LTG design? LTGs meet once a week for approximately 1 hour. LTGs are groups of two or three. When a fourth person joins, the group should multiply into two groups of two. So this should never grow beyond three people. As soon as you get to four people, within a month, the goal is to multiply into two groups of two and invite a third person. LTGs are not co-ed, but gender-specific, and we'll see why in a minute. There is no curriculum, workbook, or training involved. This is one reason this is so reproducible. You don't have to wait for Lifeway or some Christian organization to come out with something, some curriculum that it constantly involves money. All you need is each other in the Bible. And then there's no leader needed in the group, because as a kingdom priesthood, this is all built around that, that we are disciples that make disciples, okay? So there are three things we do in every LTG group meeting. There are only three tasks that are to be accomplished. The first is that sin is confessed in mutual accountability. Second, scripture is read repetitively in context and in community. And then third, souls are prayed for strategically, specifically, and continuously. So all we do in life transformation groups are three things. We confess our sin, we talk about our scripture reading each week, and then we pray strategically that we would share the gospel with at least three people each week that we believe are those Luke 10 persons of peace. That's it. There's a key. There are many keys to the success of that life transformation groups. Number one, there are only two suggested qualifications for starting or joining an LTG. First of all, we are looking for people who have a desperate need for Jesus Christ. Just as Jesus said to the Pharisees, "I've not come to save those who are sick, those who are well, but those who are sick." Because those who are well don't need a doctor, but those who are sick. And the big joke on the Pharisees is the Pharisees don't see their own sickness. So we don't just launch a program of life transformation groups in our church. We, as people who are desperate disciples of Jesus, who are desperate for Jesus, we're going out there looking for people who hunger for the Lord, because that's where the internal motivation comes in. Second is faithfulness to the process itself. Okay, the goal is not to start an LTG and never start another one. The goal is to multiply these as we make disciples. These two criteria balance one another to keep the group on track, both with healing for hurting people and health for helping people. So when we are going out and we're starting life transformation group with broken sinners, this is going to bring healing, because they're reading the Word, and they're being prayed for, and they're confessing their sins. But then, over time, life transformation groups will help build mature believers who need continued health in order that they can continue to help people. And then the third part is to compromise either in these principles will slow down or derail the effectiveness of the group. And so, if we stop being desperate for Jesus, we'll stop being faithful to the process. If we stop being faithful to the process, then it's going to be hard to multiply, because the group will no longer be healthy. So let's start with the first part, sin, confession, and accountability. Christians need one another. Beginning with confession of sin tends to sanctify the rest of the meeting. So when we're meeting together and we begin confessing our sins to each other, then we really begin to understand our need, not just for life transformation groups, but for the Word, for one another, for prayer, and for ongoing sin confession. So each person takes turn answering the questions we're about to look at. The confession of sin prepares the soil of people's hearts for the Word of God being read each week. So as we confess our sins continually, repetitively, and regularly, we begin to understand over and over and over again why our greatest need is the Word of God. Because Jesus says, "I am the bread of life." And so the place to go is Jesus, not a program. And then, of course, this is all based on James 5:16. "Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed." Do you want to be healed? Do you want to find joy in your life? Do you want to find healing for habitual sin in your life? Then confess your sins to each other. That's the key. So there are 10 questions. Let's look at them. Every week, guys get with guys and girls get with girls, and each person has an opportunity to answer the following questions. Have you been a testimony this week to the greatness of Jesus Christ with both your words and actions? Have you been exposed to sexually alluring material or allowed your mind to entertain inappropriate sexual thoughts about another this week? Have you lacked integrity in your financial dealings or coveted something that does not belong to you? Have you been honoring and understanding and generous in your important relationships this week? Have you damaged another person by your words, either behind their back or face to face? Have you given into an addictive behavior this past week? Explain. Have you continued to remain angry toward another? Have you secretly wished for another's misfortune? Then number 9 is your personalized accountability question. If there's something you know you always struggle with and you are having trouble with victory over it, then you write that question so your brothers or your sisters respectively can keep you accountable to it each week. 10, did you finish the reading and hear from God? What are you going to do about it? Then 11, have you been completely honest with me? Can you imagine the transformation that would happen in our existing church culture if every man, woman, teenager got together with a couple brothers or a couple sisters and they started confronting each other with these 11 questions every week? We would be transformed from the inside out. The second part is repetitive scripture reading. It's based on these things. The power of the system is in the unleashing of God's word in the lives of people. Just like David Platt says in Radical Together, let the word do the work. Going back to what we've talked about in Hebrews and what we've talked about in 2 Timothy 3:16, all scriptures God breathed, it's useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the person of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. Let the word do the work. To expect lives to be changed and bear fruit without first planting the seed is foolish, and disappointment will result. This entire program, these principles, this method always depends on a lot of God's word doing its work. The goal is to create an internal appetite for the rich word of God, so a larger volume of scripture is desired. So reading entire Bible books in repetition in context and in community will yield rich rewards. So each week, this group of two or three commit to read 25 to 30 chapters a week. So let's say that you and I start a life transformation group. We want to read Ephesians. Ephesians has 6 chapters, so we commit to read Ephesians 5 times. 6 chapters times 5 is 30. Can you imagine how much we would learn about the book of Ephesians or the letter of Ephesians if we read through it 5 times? And so this is so essential to this part. Each group decides on which book or portion of a book to read repetitively. It's not a bad thing for everyone not to finish the reading each week. 30 chapters tends to take about 4 weeks for a typical group to finish reading together. Why? Because it's hard to read 30 chapters of scripture a week. So if you get together and it's the second week and you've committed to read Ephesians 6 5 times and not everybody did it, well then you commit that week not to just finish reading it 5 times, but to start over and that week commit to read 30 chapters of scripture each week. A group can decide together what the next book will be or alternate who chooses the book each time. So if you're going to read through Genesis and you take 10 chapters a week and that's 3 times because that would be 30 chapters, then you would read through Genesis starting with the first 10 chapters and the next 10 chapters and so on and so forth. And then David Platt again says the word does the work. So this is building on the understanding that Jesus builds his church by making disciples who hunger for his word and walk by his spirit. And then the third part, there was confession of sin, there's repetitive reading of large volumes of scripture each week, and then repetitive strategic prayer. Each card has a strategic prayer focus you can download from their website. Built into daily scripture reading is daily intercessory prayer. Each LTG member identifies 3 people whom the Lord lays on their hearts that need Jesus. Those who began to seek Christ become perfect candidates for the next LTG, and multiplication of the group can occur naturally and spontaneously and in a way that the whole group can rejoice. And we build this on Romans 10:1. Brethren, my heart's desire and my prayer for them is for their salvation. So here's what we're praying for 3 lost people per person every week, every day. Lord, I pray that you would draw this person to yourself. I pray that this person will seek to know you. I pray that this person will hear and believe the word of God for what it really is. I ask you, Lord, to prevent Satan from blinding this person to the truth. Holy Spirit, I ask you to convict this person of sin and the need for Christ's redemption. I ask that you send someone who will share the gospel with this person. I also ask that you give me or someone else the opportunity, the courage, and the right words to share with this person. Lord, I pray that this person will turn from sin and follow Christ. Lord, I pray that this person will put all of his or her trust in Christ. And here's the key to multiplication and disciple-making fruit. Lord, I pray that this person will confess Christ as Lord, grow in faith, and bear fruit for your glory. So here we go. Proverbs 27:17 says, the strength of 2 or 3 in these 5 areas. We've got community. Life change happens in relationship. Accountability. We need help from each other. Confidentiality, smaller groups maintain trust, and can I get an amen on that? Flexibility, smaller groups means more options, and reproducibility, transformed disciples and community are the base unit for the kingdom of God. So that's life transformation groups. If you have any more questions, send me an email, but go to cmaresources.org, check it out, read Cultivating a Life for God by Neil Cole, do some research, but I would encourage you, I would challenge you, I could not recommend these principles more to